Hello everyone and welcome to this week's Game Development Log Video Diary, and this week I'm going to be getting stuck into the combat system and adding some attacks into the game. To kick the week off, I've added the concept of attacks into the code, and I've also added this abilities bar at the bottom of the screen with a few attacks already displayed in it. They don't do anything yet, of course, but I'll be adding a bit more functionality tomorrow. It is Tuesday and I've done a bit more work on the attack bar today. The attacks that you can use now depend on what weapon you're holding, so at the moment I haven't got any weapons equipped, so I obviously have no available attacks, but if I go ahead and wield a sword, you can see that I've now got this slash attack here. And I've also added a mouse over feature so you can see what the attacks are called. And if I swap to a mage weapon, you'll see that I have different attacks available for me to use. As well as that, I've started working on the attack animations, which I'll be putting into the game very soon. So it's the middle of the week, and today I've made some good progress on the functionality of the attacks. The first thing you'll notice is that the attack icons now have these little numbers by each one, and these show what key you have to press to activate the attack. So I'll go ahead and press 1 on my keyboard to activate missiles, and I've added this effect here to show that the attack is in progress. Other attacks have this lightning sign next to them, and these attacks need to be charged up first. So if I press 2, the sign goes red to show that it's charging, and then it goes blue to show that it's charged. And now I can press 2 again whenever I want to activate the attack. Thursday, and today I've put the attack animations into the game. I've been working really hard to create some really top quality, super realistic, ferocious looking attack animations, and I failed miserably and ended up with this and this. I'd just like to assure you at this point that I will most definitely not be doing the animating for the final game, and all of the animations you see at this point are just placeholders. It is Friday, and today I've got the basics of melee combat to work in multiplayer. I know the timing's still a bit off and there's loads still to do, but you can at least now damage other players with your ridiculous looking attacks. If you use a better sword, you'll actually deal more damage to the other player, as you can see here. And I can also now demonstrate an attack that needs charging. So this crush attack here, I press 3 once to charge it, and once it's charged I can press 3 again to unleash hell. And finally this week, I got slightly distracted and made a few new plants for the game, so the world now looks a bit greener, which is lovely. But also I reshuffled a load of code so that the players can now attack mobs as well as other players, which would be fantastic except for the fact that I don't actually have any mobs in the game yet. And so I took to Blender to make this groundbreakingly high definition realistic model of a rabbit, which will be making its way into the game next week. But for this week, that is it. Next time, I'm going to be working on magic and ranged attacks, and I think that video will be out in 2 weeks' time, because next week I'm just going to be redoing the server client code a bit, which wouldn't make for a very exciting video. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Do leave any comments or feedback about this week's update. I'd love to know what you guys think about it. But thank you guys so much for watching. Do subscribe if you haven't already. Have a wonderful week, and I will see you all next time.